جاي من كل مكان الصورة زينة البلدان زورو ونرجع فرحان كفى بالو للهلولة حد سلحو ثوم حيلة نضربو شوفارة الليلة
بشوت مغاية لربوتاي بشوت غاف شاليتا And always is I'm happy to be here with you. This Kila Kedusha with a good Rav Baruch Hashem that you have. And how much it's a pleasure to listen, to hear the way how he explained the halachot. When you know, when you understand each halach how to do it, so you do it. But to do it, you must have somebody to explain it well. Baruch Hashem, you have this kind of Rav who explained you the halacha so well, so it gives pleasure to do it. Yesterday, Shabbat, when I was learning the story of Yosef HaTzadik, the way his brothers did it to him, I was thinking, what happened exactly to Yosef HaTzadik? The one that he was a big tzaddik, he is the only one that we call him Yosef HaTzadik. That means he was a tzaddik. What we don't understand is the way when he had the two dreams and he tell to his brothers the dreams that he had, those kind of dreams, they were very, very bad dreams. Just can you imagine if one of your brothers will tell you that that you bend yourself to him, who will accept that? Even that Yosef HaTzadik had those kind of dreams, he should not tell them, because those kind of dreams, they can only create some kind of hate between brothers. Of course, they will hate him, they will not like him. And besides this, how do you explain the way that Yosef HaTzadik, he spoke Lashon Hara, he spoke bad language about his brothers to his father? I mean, we don't understand if he was a tzaddik, how can he say to his father things against his brother? How do you understand this? And besides this, how would you explain the way that Yaakov Avinu, that he was a big tzaddik, always he was learning Torah with Yosef HaTzadik? I mean, of course, he can make his brothers jealous. I mean, it's not normal to study Torah only with one. If you have 11, 12 children, you study Torah with the 12 children. But Yaakov Avinu, Eli Todot Yaakov Yosef, it's like Yaakov Avinu, all his life was Yosef. I mean, Yaakov, you're making that your children, they will hate Yosef. So how can you do that, Yaakov? And besides this, he made for him a special clothes, kotonit pasim, a special shirt, expensive shirt. I mean, that as well can bring, jealousy between brothers. And besides this, my friend, as you see, always this parasha, with study this parasha during this time of the year near Hanukkah. And this is something that we have to understand. Rabotai, you must know that all the reason why the Jews in Eretz Israel, they started to be assimilated to the Greek only because of one reason. Only because of one reason. They did not study Torah as you should study Torah. When you study Torah, you study Torah to do it, not only to listen a lecture, and then bye-bye. No, when you listen a lecture of Torah, you have to do it. You listen a halacha, you have to do it. The problem, my friend, that the Jews at that time, they had everything they wanted. Baruch Hashem, Eretz Israel, the Beit HaMikdash, the business was good, no problems with the neighbors, and then they started to study Torah, but very, very slowly, not as it should be. And because of that, unfortunately, they started to be assimilated to the Greek. Little by little, they drop by drop, and then, unfortunately, most of them, they were assimilated. And Baruch Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he sent the Hashmonaim to fight the Greek to throw them out of Israel. Rabotai, Yosef HaTzadik, if Yaakov Avinu, he chose Yosef HaTzadik, because Yosef HaTzadik, he did not have any kind of, when he has time, he will come to study Torah with his father. All the time that he had, he studied Torah with his father. Yosef, from the word Mosif, always he had. So when Yaakov Avinu, of course Yaakov Avinu, he had 12 children, but the only one who showed really that he wanted to study Torah more than everybody, it was Yosef. Yosef. And that's why Yaakov Avinu, he was always, Yosef was available. If the brothers, they had something to do, Yosef was available to study Torah. And that's why Yaakov Avinu, he loved Yosef more than everyone. Just imagine, how can Yosef HaTzadik can study all the Torah that Yaakov Avinu studied during his life? How it's possible? How it's possible? A man of 17 years old, Yaakov Avinu, he teach him all the Torah that he knew. How? It's impossible. But this is, Rabotai, the emet. Anyone who loves Torah, and Bemet he loves Torah, and any time that he has, or he create time to study Torah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will give him some kind of understanding, wisdom, that he can catch everything. Yosef HaTzadik, he catch all the Torah that Yosef, Yaakov Avinu, he studied during his life in a short years. Why? Because Yosef HaTzadik, he showed that really he loved Torah. And this is the reason why Yaakov Avinu, he loved him. And this is the reason why Yosef HaTzadik, he catch all that Torah. And this is the reason why Yosef HaTzadik, when he went to Egypt, he was the only Jew in Egypt, and everybody wanted his approach. He was a handsome boy, a very, very handsome, and Baruch Hashem, the Torah protected him. Why? Because anyone who is Mosif, Mosif Imlo. Anyone, usually people, they have a timing. When I have time, I will go to listen to Shiur. Everyone has his own timing. Yosef HaTzadik has no timing. Yosef HaTzadik, all his life was sitting and look, and that was protecting him in Egypt. And that's why Yaakov Avinu, he loved him. And my friend, now we understand why Yosef HaTzadik, he spoke bad. I mean, he was dumb, like Yaakov Avinu. Ele, Vayeishev, Yaakov, Ishtam, Yosef, Ohalim. All the life of Yaakov Avinu, he was a dumb. He was a man, he was not a gangster, a mafia, or he was a Ramai, you know. He talked to you in a way and he fixed something else. It was a tzaddik, tam. Yaakov, ishtam, Yosef, Ohalim. So Yosef HaTzadik was as well tam. He was humble. He did not have anything, bad thoughts. So when he had a dream, he thought it's normal that he would tell them to his brothers. He didn't think, Chas v'Shalom, that this dream will create some kind of sin, a hate between him and his brother. He thought it's normal. If I had this dream, that means that I have to say that dream. He didn't tell them. If he knew, of course, that those dreams will create some kind of hate, sinah between them, I'm sure that he will not say that to it. It's not possible that he will say to his father, "Papa, I had a dream that you and my mother and all of you were bent to me." Of course, he will not say that. And if he said those kind of dreams, because he was a tzaddik, because he was dumb, he thought it's normal to. With no hashusha, with no any bad thought or meaning, he said that to his brother. But unfortunately, that created, you know, hate between his brothers. And from that, something good came, that he was sold to Egypt, and then he prepared to his family to come to Egypt. And that's the way that it started the avdut, to be slave in Egypt. But all what you can learn from this story is that Yosef HaTzadik, he was alone in Egypt, with no family, with no parent, with no mother, with nobody, just himself. And he remained a big tzaddik. Big tzaddik. When a few years later, when he met his father, he told his father, "Papa, all the Torah that I learned from you, I can repeat it to you. That's what protected me here." And this is, Rabotei, something that all of us, we have to learn. Look the difference between Yosef and the Jews at the time of the Hashmonaim, that they were assimilated. Millions of Jews were assimilated. Why? Because they did not, it's only the Torah who can protect. Only the Torah Kedusha. And that this is something that all of us should know. And that's why every year, when we light the Hanukkah, we light the Hanukkah, all what we say when we light the Hanukkah, to remember what the Greek they wanted to do to us. What they wanted to do to us? They wanted to assimilate us. But who's the fault? We or the Greek? The answer is, we are the fault. Because Baruch Hashem today, it's easy to be assimilated, even today. But with the Torah, with the Halakha, with the Tfilot, that help you to live, to remain a good Jew, wherever you are. So this is something to learn from Yosef HaTzadik and us. What protects Yosef? The Torah that his father teach him. What protects Yosef? Because Yosef, he has no limit time when to study Torah. All the time was his time to study Torah. That helped him. Why Yaakov Abinu loved Yosef? Because of this. So Rabotei, Be'ezat Hashem, for the Chanukah, for this light to the Chanukah, we learn how much we have to be connected. This Anerot Halalu, Kodeshem, Be'elanu Rishut, when we look at the light of the Chanukah, we think about what? We think about Torah. Torah, that's it, this is the nest. The nest of Chanukah is that Baruch Hashem, we did not be assimilated, and Baruch Hashem, we remain with the Torah, and this is something that we have to give it to from generation to generation. Yeh Ratzon Shenizkeh Be'ezrat Hashem, Liviat Mashiach Tzidkenu Be'Mehra V'Yameinu Amen.